Good afternoon. Welcome back to Lansing. The International WFTDA 2016 Division II Playoffs. I'm Danny Mack, joined by Captain Lou Albamo. Lou, a big matchup, a rematch already, the kind of thing you don't typically see in these playoffs, but a rematch of international proportions.
Absolutely true, yeah. I mean, they faced off on day one. It's going to be Bear City Roller Derby, the 8 seed, ranked 56th in the WFTDA, facing off against Tri-City Roller Derby, the 9 seed, 59th in the WFTDA. Again, faced off on the Friday. Bear City coming away with a convincing win, 235-140. I think a lot of people thought the game would be a lot closer. I don't think Tri-City played their best game on Friday. And Tri-City sort of ran the table after that, won two games yesterday. Bear City losing to Charm and then winning yesterday over Cincinnati got them back into the 5-6 game. Both teams are going to be improving their seeding once they come out of this tournament.
And considerably. I mean, the at stake here is that fifth place finish, out of the money, out of the medals, as it were, but a fifth place finish nonetheless, the potential for going up 3 or 4 seeds respectively. This here tournament brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Lansing Derby Vixens. Lou, get us the rosters here for the 9th-ranked Tri-City Roller Derby.
Tri-City Roller Derby out of Kitchener-Waterloo, Cambridge, Ontario, Canada. They are bringing to the table today number 0, Andy Slamberg, 03, Dangerous, 13, Rain Blows Bright, 1321, Kay Skelton, Annex is number 14, 2042, Agrosaurus, 231, Crazy Squirrel. You'll hear a lot about her today. Antastic, number 24, 266, Smashing Good Time, 303, Violent No Regard, 42, Megan Plead, 64, Cannonball Doll, 711, Pity a Foo, and number 84, Megantron.
For Bear City Roller Derby, they are the Berlin Bombshells from Berlin, Germany. They will start with number 030, that's Jane Van Payne. Number 105 is Miss Mercury. Number 109, Amazon. Number 1858, Minnesota Nice. 190, a name you'll hear quite a bit, Peanut Butter Panic. 22, that's Donner Doro. Number 23 is Sixie Blitz. Number 247, Catherine Beat Her Bones. Mia Missile wears number 25, the highest scoring player on this Bear City team, the potential to put up massive amounts of numbers. Lizzie Slaughter wears number 42. 505 is Heavy Rotation. 666, that's Hannah Satana. Number 71, Mick Her Cry. And number 77 is Foxy Fuhrer.
Don't forget, if you want to talk to us via the social medias, please use the hashtag Talk2. That's number 2 WFTDA. Danny Mack, we are moments away from getting the 5-6 game to start. And on that Fast Girl start line, Mia Missile, you mentioned her, and I mentioned Crazy Squirrel. Not surprising that the top scorers from each team are starting the game.
Let's roll out the big guns. And the start looks very, very segregated at the moment. Tri-City will begin at the jammer line but move their forepod backward. And Bear City will attack from the rear part of the pack. There goes Crazy Squirrel inside. Mia Missile will go outside. And Crazy Squirrel, lead jammer to start things off for Tri-City.
Crazy Squirrel getting stronger and stronger as the tournament goes on. 259 points. She was the top scorer after day two in this tournament.
Tri-City wearing black and Bear City wearing white. Called off with 2 points on the board. Bear City strikes first.
No, they'll switch it up. Give
yeah,
it back
there it
to Tri-City.
Tri-City in black strikes first. 2-0. About 35 seconds elapsed on the clock.
And second jam of the game is going to get Smashing Good Time for Tri-City. Tri-City shaking it up a bit. Smashing Good Time has jammed a bit this weekend, but she's not been part of the regular rotation. And it's number 190, Peanut Butter Panic. Peanut Butter Panic with 201 points on the weekend. Was the top scorer in the game against Tri-City on Friday.
PBP goes into what's a four-wall setup and now braced at the front by Tri-City. Peanut Butter Panic takes advantage at least forward on the track from her counterpart or jamming counterpart. Smashing Good Time, also high scoring potential. These are two teams, when they are clicking, the numbers will just continue to creep on the scoreboard.
Yeah, both teams have put up impressive results this weekend. Bear City with the largest differential score against Cincinnati yesterday. Tri-City with the smallest differential score against Niederreuss.
It's always interesting throughout a tournament to see who can adjust. Inside goes Peanut Butter Panic. Lead jammer for Bear City. Oh, excuse me. Boy, I am striking out here already. That is smashing good time who got out. Peanut Butter Panic now getting a big shoulder blow from Christy Skelton, and she will leave cutting the track.
So interesting thing with the jammer penalties. Tri-City has actually reduced their jammer penalties in each game they've played this weekend. Bear City has increased their jammer penalties in each game.
Tri-City with an advantage on the track and a power jam. 7-0. The Canadians leading the Germans. Peanut Butter Panic standing up from the penalty box, now smashing good time, will enter a wall of white. Smashing good time now. Two blockers up front as the pack has gone spread. And bridging in the middle of the pack will be a Bear City player.
The Smashing Good Time playing very patient jammer awareness on there. Managed to push them past the 20 feet. Out of play penalty is going to take two blockers from Bear City off there, Danny Mack.
Actually, that will take the jammer who has tucked the start. Peanut Butter Panic.
Back into the box. The 888 penalty box seeing a lot of action from Bear City early on in this game. Two penalties to Peanut Butter Panic. She's had 11 on the weekend. She had three in the game against Tri-City on Friday. Two early on in this game. Double or back-to-back power jam is going to be a power start for Tri-City. 10 points in that jam, 12-0 on the scoreboard. 26 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in the first half. Megan Tron with the star, Danny.
Handsiness getting the better of the jammer. There goes Megan Tron. She has been a big-time player for this Tri-City team and continues. Lead jammer.
Megan Tron with 178 points on the weekend, 87 points yesterday against Sac City.
Megan Tron with a 12-0 lead, 26 minutes, 19 seconds to go. Peanut Butter Panic will be re-entering the track, down by another 5 points in this jam. 17-0 is the current score. Megan Tron on her second go-round. Peanut Butter Panic has returned. She is being drawn back again by Tri-City. Tri-City took the jammer back. That was Pain Blows Bright a little bit, probably about 15 feet back.
Andy Slamberg with a multiplayer block there, Danny.
Andy Slamberg, a very aggressive player, fantastic as well. This is kind of the aggressor pack for Tri-City. When they want to run out some bruisers, this is who they bring onto the floor.
Tri-City with another 4 points at the end of the jam, 9 total in that jam, 21-0. They run up the score in the first 4.5 minutes of this game, 25 and a half remaining in the half. Bear City coming out a little cold off the start of this. They're going to take Donner Doro out onto the fast girl start line. Crazy Squirrel, again, continuing to be in heavy rotation for Tri-City. See if Donner Doro can change momentum in favor of the Germans.
The whistle tweets, and we have elapsed 5 minutes in period number one. Inside, Tri-City will get called for a penalty, a forearm.
That was a real problem for Tri-City against Bear City in the first game, Danny.
21-0, Tri-City has a lead, but their high scorer sitting in the 888 penalty box, Donner Doro, trying to crack the scoreboard for Bear City.
The Crazy Squirrel with 4 trips to the penalty box in the first half of the game on Friday.
Donner Doro now gets up the front. Dangerous will meet her and then pass her off to another couple of players.
That's Slamberg getting the hit out there, Danny.
Slamberg's been sort of that last point of defense for this Tri-City pack all weekend. On the inside now goes Donner Doro. Now she'll hit that 4-wall. Crazy Squirrel has returned. She's tucked the star and is now behind 3 Bear City blockers. Crazy Squirrel gets back around and had one player to beat before she got shoved out of bounds. Actually stayed in bounds and got passed. So 5 more points there for Donner Doro. Crazy Squirrel still struggling. Now a brace 3-wall, which has shoved her back again. Tri-City's Crazy Squirrel is being held down, a rare instance of seeing such a thing. Penalties perhaps have made her a little more tentative. You see, not quite as aggressive with their hands as she comes hot into a pack. 5 more points. on the board for Bear City. Crazy Squirrel has returned. She is not the jammer of record at present. She doesn't have that jammer star returned to the helmet. 21-10, the current score.
60 Blitz with her second penalty as the jam comes to its end. Three additional points picked up by Bear City. The first 13 points of the game scored in that jam for the Germans. 21-13, the scoreboard, 8 points separating these teams. 22 minutes, 45 seconds remaining in the half. Tri-City, their jammer rotation really focusing on Crazy Squirrel. Crazy Squirrel, the top scorer in all three games they played. Bear City, they've got a more round rotation. They've had a different top scorer in each of the three games they've played this weekend.
Jane Van Payne on the fast girl start line for Bear City, facing Pity Afu for Tri-City. Tri-City leading 21-13, 22 minutes, 19 seconds to go in the first. Pity Afu getting walled off in the back by two players. Bear City bracing to stretch that pack apart and give their jammer maximum space. Jane Van Payne gets through, lead jammer Bear City.
Jane Van Payne has 140 points on the weekend, scored 47 points against Charm, was the top scorer for Bear City in that game.
Andy Slamberg heading to the penalty box, her second trip. The pivot for the Berlin Bombshells is Mick. She's heading to the, or Mech, as she heads the box as well, the captain.
Yeah, that aggression by Slamberg can get her in trouble. She's had 14 penalties on the weekend.
Jane Van Payne gets swallowed back up as she's knocked to the inside. Her team trails by eight. 21 minutes, 27 seconds to go in the first period. There goes Jane Van Payne.
Speaking of penalty problems, 60 Blitz heading to the triple eight penalty box for the third time in this half, only 9 minutes gone in the game.
Bear City only had a blocker on the track ahead of Jane Van Payne. And another penalty called, another jammer penalty, forearm will send Jane Van Payne to the box. There's 25 seconds left in the jam.
So Bear City had almost taken the lead in this game. That penalty is going to reverse fortunes one more time.
Yeah, GVP will have some points coming her way. Bear City, penalty trouble hurting them early. They have exerted a lot more force at points, especially in this jam prior to that penalty. 26-18, Tri-City. Pass the star to Annex.
Yeah, Annex used to be part of the regular jammer rotation for Tri-City. Prefers blocking, so she'll wear the stripe from time to time. Took that star pass from Pity Afu. Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in the roller skating industry for over 70 years, rydellskates.com. Interesting thing about Pity Afu, not really part of the regular jammer rotation for Tri-City during the regular season, only averaged 2 points per game. Called into service because Dangerous, who usually is, had an injury to her back due to portaging a canoe last weekend.
30-20 is Tri-City's lead over Bear City.
Megantron, the jammer for Tri-City, and out of the box, there's Jane Van Payne.
Yep, Jane Van Payne will return. It was going awfully great for her until a forearm penalty upended her previous jam. Megantron, two players to beat. Bear City holds on as long as they can. A high block called on Megantron. She'll sit for 30.
And this is the thing that Tri-City cannot do if they want to compete with Bear City. They can't commit as many jammer penalties as the Berlin skaters do.
Can Bear City capitalize right now? GVP's having a lot of trouble getting between what's now a very tight four wall. That four wall will spread apart slightly, but still favor the inside. Now they'll go outside as Jane Van Payne does so. Jane Van Payne now working flat-footed, was working toe stops for a while. Cuts inside, then back out.
Violent no regard heading to the triple eight penalty box for direction of gameplay.
Jane Van Payne with her team trailing by 20. That penalty, the jammer penalty had worked off. And another blocker penalty taken by Tri-City.
Again, another direction of gameplay. That's Cannonball Doll this time.
One-on-one in the rear of the pack for Tri-City. Working over that jammer was Christy Skelton. Skelton's been quite a weapon for Tri-City this weekend, sometimes donning the star, often being past the star when it comes to offensive moves, but she has been a terrific positional blocker, one-on-one style all weekend.
Looks like Berlin's going to lose Catherine Beater Bones for trip number three as well. Danny Mack, no additional points on that final pass. No points scored in that jam.
Wow.
A tough two-minute jam. And again, we're on day three of this tournament, a wonderful tournament in Lansing, Michigan. It's been great all weekend long. This is the fourth game of the weekend for these teams. Yeah, they're familiar with each other because they played on Friday. But, you know, fatigue is going to become a factor at some point.
It's got to be. And you are seeing it in some of these players. And not to single out Jane Van Payne, but she's among them. You're seeing just a lot of, a lot of excess footwork in a lot of cases. Cannonball Doll will return to the track. 30-20 remains the Tri-City lead. 17-20 on the clock. Lead jammer, Tri-City.
First lead jammer and last four jams for Tri-City.
And Bear City has not been able to capitalize big time enough on those lead jammers. Mia Missel has returned out of the pack. 4 points on the board for Tri-City.
34-20 the score, 17 minutes remaining in the game. The Crazy Squirrel getting the better of Mia Missel in that matchup on the weekend. Again, 259 points for Crazy Squirrel, 229 points for Mia Missel. They both had a game, their third game, where they both scored 127 points in the game. So you know there are skaters that can throw points up on the board in a hurry. Peanut Butter Panic is going to be next, up against Jangerous, who I mentioned with that portaging injury. Apparently she's healed enough to try to take the star.
Jangerous, one of the leading scorers on the team in the regular season. A forearm call.
That is the third penalty on Peanut Butter Panic.
Wow. So she will sit in the 888 penalty box, and lead jammer goes to Jangerous. Jangerous has been a very, very solid blocker for Tri-City. Can play any position on the floor.
Yeah, she's a transfer. Came over with Smashing Good Time from Hammer City late last year.
Extremely strong player. 5 points and looking for more. 39-20 is Tri-City's lead. Jangerous cuts through deftly.
Second scoring pass makes it 10 in this jam, Danny.
10 total points for Jangerous. She is stacking it on. Bear City will now get some shirts on her and try to hold the outside line. Jangerous so much stronger, it seems, than even a couple of blockers at times.
Just wonder if Tri-City's been saving her in reserve as a secret weapon.
It's possible. She is at a leverage disadvantage in some cases from her height, but makes up for it in technique.
She's usually a very patient jammer as well, and she's showing that under duress at the front of this pack.
Pack has come to a crawl. Star pass successful for Tri-City, or for Bear City rather, and that forces the call off.
14 points on the jam though for Tri-City. 48-20 is the score. The Canadians running up a 28-point lead with 14 minutes, 45 seconds remaining in the first half. We would like to thank 888 helmets, pads, wrist guards. We've got you covered, 888.com. On the fast girl start line, Megantron going to take the star one more time for Tri-City. That's Donner Doro wielding the star on her helmet for Berlin.
We are now beyond midway through period number one. 48-20, Tri-City's lead. Donner Doro gets shoved inside. Now works back toward the inside. A block that just barely caught the jammer. That block applied by Tri-City's Annex at seemingly the last second before Donner Doro took the entire inside. Donner Doro still stuck in the back of the pack for Tri-City. Up at the front, that's Megantron. Two players to beat as Bear City continues to bridge and waterfall their blockers forward. Penalty taken by Mech, who will sit down. Mech now has two trips to the box. Megantron out with Donner Doro right on her rear.
So no points scored in the jam. Score remains 48-20, 13 minutes, 28 seconds remaining in the first half. Get some officials read off. The referee's crew head calling the shots inside pack is Ogre. Jammer refs are Kieran Duncan and Rollbar. OPRs outside pack refs are Epic Brandemic, Ermagerd Referer, and Landon Flat. And our referee, Alt, announcer ref, is Guinness Leary.
Fast Girl start line. That's High Scorer Crazy Squirrel. High Scorer in general, not quite in this bout. That goes to Dangerous for Tri-City. And jamming for the Berlin Bombshells, that is Jane Van Payne. She has a trip to the box already, and that will be the inside. That will be Tri-City with the lead jammer, Crazy Squirrel. Time to try to get her hot if you're Tri-City.
10 jams in, Tri-City with 7 lead jammer statuses.
Mech returns to the floor. Empty 888 penalty box. 48-20 is the score, Tri-City over Bear City. Jane Van Payne and Crazy Squirrel both held back. The pack begins to speed up, spread apart just enough for Crazy Squirrel to get a little bit of room, and she will get through.
Showing that agility that helped her defeat Nidaros yesterday with that flying apex jump at the end of the game.
Spinorama from Crazy Squirrel past Catherine Beater Bones, and she'll go right back at it.
Illegal procedure, illegal, incorrect, improper star pass. That's going to send Jane Van Payne to the 888 penalty box. Power jam, Tri-City.
That one could hurt as Crazy Squirrel continues to work. She'll have 45 seconds to try to stack on more. 10 points already for Crazy Squirrel. Front of the pack becomes owned by Bear City. Tri-City will start with the back and then work the offense. Crazy Squirrel managed to stay somehow in bounds, absorbing a blow outside and then inside. 5 points, 15 total.
Mech picking up another penalty on that pass. 888 penalty box has seen her with regularity in this game. 3 trips now.
Meanwhile, an equally nice shot absorption by the Bear City jammer as Jane Van Payne stayed in bounds enough to force the call off by Tri-City.
15-0 in that jam. Tri-City now 43 points in advance of Bear City, 63-20 on the scoreboard. 10 minutes, 50 seconds remaining in the first half. Fast Girl Skates is proud to sponsor the 2016 Wftda Tournament MVPs. You'll find out who they will be at the conclusion of the championship game later today. And on the Fast Girl start line, Peanut Butter Panic with 3 penalties already up against Smashing Good Time.
Smashing Good Time will take the outside and now work inward. Peanut Butter Panic, lead jammer for Bear City. Right out of the gate, however, is Tri-City's jammer Smashing Good Time. How will the pack adjust to this? It'll go a little quicker. Tri-City toward the front. Peanut Butter Panic calls it falling out of bounds. A 2 spot for Bear City. That breaks a bit of a drought.
And Andy Slamberg, at the conclusion of that jam, had a leg out there, picked up the low block. She sits in the 888 penalty box. Trip number 3 for Andy Slamberg. Again, physical blocker for Tri-City. Part of the pest line out there. Likes to knock people down, make them feel bad about themselves. 63-22 the score. 9 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in the half. Mia Missile.
Megantron going for Tri-City as Mia Missile. It will be important for them to get her in there often. Megantron takes lead jammer. Mia Missile, Cheshire grin on her face as they now engage. What will Megantron do? Will she try to run some clock? And it looks like the pack is going to do that. Tri-City pushing it forward and at times pushing the Bear City blockers forward. Attempted apex jump on the inside by Mia Missile.
She's heading to the box, Danny Mack.
Was it a
It was a misconduct. Low block. Low block made contact with the bottom part of one of the skaters' legs. I believe it was Violent No Regard who tumbled to the ground. She'll take a seat. Too much risk for no reward.
Lou, you can see a little bit. It is early, but you can see a little bit of the more risky maneuvers now being taken by Bear City to try to get something going.
Yeah, I mean, when that desperation sinks in, especially when you've played 4 games, or playing your 4th game, 5 points picked up there by Megantron. And it's man, Mia Missile not getting, she got 0 points in that jam. There's going to be a little timeout being called by Tri-City at the conclusion of that jam. But Mia Missel, again, top scorer on Berlin for this weekend, has been out there three times, has 0 points in this game. She's going to get to go out for a fourth time because she's going to be in the triple eight penalty box. But that's a concern if you're Berlin. I mean, if your top scorer is not scoring.
It is. And I noticed at the end of the Berlin Bombshells last bout, Mia Missel left the game and appeared to just be on the sideline stretching. I don't know if that was, I mean, they had it, the game well in hand at that point. It was against Cincinnati. They ended up doubling them up. But she spent a considerable amount of time at the end of the bout not on the floor.
The WFDDA would like to thank 5-on-5 Magazine, Derby Central, RollerCon, and Spank Alley for their support of this D2 in Lansing, Michigan. 60 seconds expire on the timeout clock. That means we get to have Derby back underway momentarily. It was Bear City that had actually taken the timeout, Danny Mac. I think it's actually a pretty good timeout for Bear City to take, even though there's only 8 minutes and 34 seconds remaining in the half. They do not want to let this game slip away any more from them, especially with Mia Missel in the penalty box. It's going to be a power start. And on the fast girl start line, Jane Jureska take the start for a second time this weekend.
68-22 is Tri-City's lead. 8.5 minutes and counting remaining in the period. Dangerous will get swallowed up by three Bear City blockers.
Back block being called on Amazon.
So Amazon will sit in the triple eight penalty box. Dangerous, as you said, Lou, very patient and jamming a lot more than she had in the previous bouts. Dangerous getting couple of hips as Annex heads to the penalty box for Tri-City. Player apiece in the sin bin.
Mia Missel out of the box, lead jammer, Danny.
And you saw her kind of clap her hands. Sometimes you just got to get over the hump. Perhaps this could be it for Mia Missel. Mia Missel, lead jammer, trailing by 46, and will get dragged back. It looked like Slamberg may have had a shot on her or somebody else toward the front of the pack. Antastic also in the area. There goes Mia Missel, will now face Antastic and have to reset behind Antastic, but Slamberg, often joined at the hip, will force her to at least think about it and inevitably reset behind her. In the front of the pack is Dangerous, who is still taking her time. And Dangerous, one player to beat. And she will do so thanks to a penalty. As Tri-City holding a 68-27 margin, but Mia Missel, lead jammer for Bear City. She'll pick up the pace. Mia Missel can beat just about anybody in this tournament in a foot race. And she's doing that against Dangerous.
Tri-City really getting that pack and hustle mode.
Man.
That's a long two-minute jam to not have any additional points put on the board. 5-0 in favor of Bear City, 68-27 on the scoreboard in favor of Tri-City. 6:20 remaining. Penalty count, 18 for Berlin Bombshells, 11 for the Tri-City Thunder. So those penalties continuing to add up. And Tri-City with 5 power jams so far, only 2 for Berlin.
Lou, that was Mia Missel's first 5 points of the bout.
6-2, sorry.
Crazy squirrel jamming for Tri-City. Donner Doro going for Bear City. Lead jammer for Tri-City, and Donner Doro heads to the penalty box.
We'll call it 7 power jams to 2.
Penalties eating Bear City alive. Tri-City, on the other hand, stacking on points. Crazy squirrel, 5 more. This bout was so close. The first bout, the first meeting between these two teams, one of the opening bouts of the tournament, ended with Crazy Squirrel jumping the apex and winning the game.
Oh, it was Nidaros, but it's, oh, it was the other European teams.
Yes.
All Europeans look alike, though. So.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
78-27, Tri-City over Bear City. 5 minutes and 4 seconds remaining. Crazy Squirrel trying to get through for more. Already 10 points in this jam. Collection of white shirts around, trying to be busted up by Agrosaurus by Tri-City.
Star pass has happened to Catherine Beater-Bones. She's put points on the board in this weekend.
And has emerged. We'll see how much of that crazy squirrel will tolerate, and not much. A few seconds in, she'll tap the hips and stop it. 82 now to 27. Tri-City shutting Bear City out in another jam.
4 minutes, 25 seconds remaining in the first half of this game. Again, it is for fifth or sixth place at the Lansing D2. Adam's skates just got a lot more colorful. You can see what kind of colors they've got at adamskates.com.
The shoe on the other foot in this bout compared to bout number one between these two teams, where Bear City rolled over Tri-City 235 to 140 and immediately looked like they were making a statement that they could contend for one of those top three spots. Megantron going for Tri-City, Jane Van Payne for Bear City. Megantron trying to go around on one skate on the outside and will be taken back.
Star stash by Jane Van Payne.
And she has emerged. Jam stopped.
No points on the board for either side. 82 to 27 is the score. You know, I talked at the beginning of the game about how over this weekend, Tri-City has kept their jammer penalties low, and Berlin has seen their jammer penalties rise with each and every game. We're seeing that in this game as well, and it has been a big difference maker in this, with seven power jams to two. Now again, top scorers of the weekend for their teams, Crazy Squirrel, Mia Missile, dueling one more time.
Crazy Squirrel will lead on the right side. Mia Missile shaking her head, did not like that back block call. She will head to the 888 penalty box for 30 seconds. Crazy Squirrel, lead jammer.
Yeah, Lizzie Slaughter in heavy rotation, also in that 888 penalty box. Only two blockers on the track. That's Miss Mercury and Catherine Beater-Bones for Berlin.
An 82 to 27 lead for Tri-City. Make it 87 to 27. A 60-point lead, the largest for Tri-City. Crazy Squirrel coming up on the back of the pack. She will engage three blockers in a braced formation. Cannonball Doll trying to get up and screw around with that three wall. Mia Missile has returned and got around Violent No Regard. Crazy Squirrel, a weak hip tap, not enough. Not enough to draw the call off, and now she does.
Check with her bench first, Danny, yep, just to make sure it was the right thing for her to do.
Oh. Yeah. Wasn't a hip tap, it was a hip bluff.
So did not give up any points to Bear City. 10-0 in that jam in favor of Tri-City, 92 to 27. They are plus seven on the power jam advantage with a minute and 40 seconds remaining in the half. Yesterday against Sac City, they were plus 15 on the power jams. One of the main reasons why they won that game, I suspect.
Tick-tock, now under 90 seconds to go in period number one. As that game clock expires, it will be the jam clock to pay attention to. 92 to 27, Tri-City. Bear City takes lead jammer.
This is what Bear City needs. They need to have some momentum to go into the dressing room at half, Danny.
Even if it's just that at this point, they're falling behind rapidly. Lead jammer's a great start, and 5 points, an even greater start.
Like any game where you take nine jammer penalties in a half, it's gonna be a rough game for your team.
Yep, they trail by 60 points. Outside goes Peanut Butter Panic.
Star pass has happened to Annex. Annex is the pivot turn jammer now for Tri-City.
As soon as she can get that star on her helmet and get out of the pack, now she'll head to the box.
So
Annex holding the panty, cutting the track. She'll sit for 30. Peanut Butter Panic, meanwhile, keeps chalking them up.
Again, she had 92 points in that first game, first meeting between Tri-City and Bear City.
20 seconds on the bout clock, 51 seconds remaining on the jam clock.
That last scoring pass put her in the lead for scoring for Berlin.
Peanut Butter Panic going the difficult way now through a braced collection of Tri-City blockers, or bridged collection rather. 5 points. She has 19 total in the jam. Period clock has ended. We have 28 seconds left on the jam clock. Annex has yet to make it through on her initial pass.
Berlin going to lose Amazon to a multiplayer block. Trip number four for her.
15 seconds. Peanut Butter Panic gets through again. 24 points. 51 points now for Bear City. They trail by 41. Peanut Butter Panic goes inside and tried to get around a staunch two wall on the interior portion of the apex between turn one and two.
No time left, Danny.
3 points more for Peanut Butter Panic.
So a huge 27 to nothing jam. They started that jam, Berlin Bear City did, with 27 points. They doubled it on the last jam of the half. They've had what would probably be considered by most a fairly miserable first half, but with throwing up 27 points, they're going to go into the dressing room, going to be down by 38. That's the kind of thing that you want if you're a fan of the German team, to see your team going back, get rest for 15 minutes, reset.
Yep.
There's obviously hope.
Oh, there's plenty of derby left to go. However, that one's a good start. I mean, if you can get a little bit of that momentum swinging back your way. As we said, 30 more minutes. Teams fighting now for that fifth place spot. An 8-team yep. Bear City, a number 9 seed Tri-City, facing off matchup number 2. It was Bear City in the first one. The shoe has turned on the other foot, at least through period number 1. Stick around. More coming up with Lou and Danny Mack on WFTDA.TV. The battle for a fifth place finish continues. I'm Danny Mack with Captain Lou. And Captain, the first bout, or the first half of this bout, was really characteristic of an anemic Berlin Bombshells offense, something we're not used to seeing.
Yeah, I mean, they were only able to put points up on the scoreboard in 5 out of the 17 jams. Game didn't start off that badly for them. They gave up a couple power jams early on, but first 5 jams, it was only 30-20 in favor of Tri-City, but then Tri-City went on a tear for the next 11 jams, fueled by all those power jams that they were given by Berlin, went on a 62-7 run, and then Tri-City gave the gift back to Bear City, and Bear City taking full advantage when Tri-City stumbled, put up a 27-point jam to end this half, and suddenly they're kind of back in it, only down by 38 points after trailing by a bundle during this half.
And really, Berlin was just not able to get anything going on offense, and Tri-City just kept playing their game. I don't see any major adjustment that they're going to need to make in this second period.
And that all depends on what Berlin does, right? I mean, Berlin giving up 9 power jams to the 3 that Tri-City had. You saw that when Tri-City gave up the power jam, it did not go well for them in that last jam of the half. 26-17 were the total penalties for the teams. So there's a problem there, and that Tri-City, again, is committing less penalties, so it makes it that much more difficult for Berlin to get back into it. Berlin has Amazon sitting at 4 penalties, Peanut Butter Panic at 3, 60 Blitz at 3, Catherine Beater Bones at 3, Heavy Rotation at 3, Mech at 3. A lot of those skaters play high levels of lines
yep.
for Berlin. They're usually on every second, if not more, and they can't lose that core blocker rotation. Or as time dwindles in this game, Berlin may find it more difficult to field a good defense.
And the big scorers, Crazy Squirrel, 45 points for Tri-City. That's sort of what we expected. That's
it is now, yeah.
Par for the course, yeah. 5 lead jammers on 7 opportunities for her. The leading scorer for the Berlin Bombshells was Peanut Butter Panic. 27 of her 29 points came in the final jam of period number 1. We've got 30 more minutes coming at you, as the players are getting ready on the fast girl start line.
The duel to see who will leave Lansing in fifth place and who will leave in sixth comes down to 30 more minutes of skating around the flat track. And Peanut Butter Panic, again, lead scorer for the Berlin Bombshells, 29 points in that first half, as Danny Mack said, will take the star against Crazy Squirrel on the fast girl start line when we get things underway momentarily.
Tri-City will begin with their 3 blockers
Amazon
near the jammer line.
Amazon and Megantron in the 888 penalty box, a 3-on-3, Danny Mack.
Annex out there, Andy Slamberg. Rain blows bright, and Megatron jamming, blocking for the jammer, Crazy Squirrel. This one starts as many others have, where the pack has not even gone around past turn one. It's 92 for Tri-City, 54 for Berlin, and a lead jammer just like that for Crazy Squirrel.
Crazy Squirrel, 86% lead jammer status in this game.
Crazy Squirrel now getting back to the rear of it, and emerging is Peanut Butter Panic.
A little bit of hit it and quit it to start the second half. Danny Mac, 4 points put on the board by Tri-City. 29 minutes, 20 seconds remaining in the half, so 40 seconds expire.
Bear City had been on that 27-point run at the very end of the period. Mia Missile back up on the Fast Girl start line.
Yeah, she's got two penalties in this game. We were wondering if perhaps she was looking a little bit tired. I mean, she's got, sort of got that first initial attack, but then seems to gas out a bit. She'll go up against Pitya Fu.
I am not surprised if she's tired, Lou. You and I are tired,
exactly.
And we're just talking about roller derby. Tri-City's 42-point lead continues, but Mia Missile out like she's accustomed to, getting lead jammer.
Yeah, the initial assault good enough to get through the pack the first time.
And she just blasts through two blockers. She sends Smashing Good Time forward and calls it off once Pitya Fu had gotten off.
Smashing Good Time's a solid skater for Tri-City, not one to tumble to the ground easily, and Mia Missile just chucked her down with that shoulder-to-shoulder contact.
And important, it was shoulder-to-shoulder, right, and not forearm or elbow or anything else that many of these jammers have fallen into.
Good and clean. Did you know that in addition to helmets, S1 now makes pads for roller derby too? Make S1 part of your uniform, S1helmets.com. Fast Girl Starline, Crazy Squirrel, and Jane Van Payne.
Crazy Squirrel will go out to in. Jane Van Payne will do the opposite. Jane Van Payne now two players in the front of the pack.
Back block to Crazy Squirrel, Danny Mack.
So Jane Van Payne with an opportunity. Here's what's important though, can Bear City get her through?
Offense coming in.
Especially with this bruiser line, Tri-City has just overmatched Bear City physically.
And Tri-City doing a good job of continuing to skate forward to avoid that offense as well, Danny.
Jane Van Payne on the now just trying to batter the blockers that are holding her back. Annex the pivot. Andy Slamberg holding back the jammer for quite a long time.
45 seconds in this jam, Danny.
Jane Van Payne now goes to the inside part of the track. There's four blockers to meet her. Jane now slogging through as turn one has come to a crawl. It's 96-58 for Tri-City. Jane Van Payne still not able to get any ground on this four wall. Bear City not really trying to get a blocker up there to bust it apart either.
Crazy Squirrel out of the box, star stash through the pack. Jam going to come to its conclusion, Danny. Four more points for Bear City, but man, that was a hard fought 4 points. Tri-City defense locking Jane Van Payne down for the duration of that jam, only giving up the single pass, not even giving up the jammer lap point. It's just 96-62 in favor of Tri-City. Berlin trying to creep their way into fifth place as they trail the Canadians. And on the Fast Girl start line, Megatron and Donadoro.
Hella good penalty kill going on. Megatron will go forward first. And she has four white shirts around her. Donadoro has four black shirts around her as Skelton will bridge the Tri-City pivot. Megatron now dances on the outside and reverses her course, spinning around and taking lead jammer.
Yeah, that freedom was bought via a track cut to 60 blitz. That's her fifth penalty of this game. Amazon also on five.
Megatron jams her shoulder into the back part of these blockers and continues going forward.
Correction, 60 on four right now. She had three before.
101-62 is Tri-City's increasing lead. Can they put it up even more?
Peter Bones trying to work her way through there, Danny.
Braced three wall for Bear City in the back. And the player holding the star right now is the Bear City pivot. And that's Catherine Beaterbones. Catherine gets out after a spinorama.
Yeah, some nice footwork there by the pivot.
So she will put the star on her helmet and now is officially in scoring mode. Call off by Megan Tron, 101-62.
Donna
104-62.
Donna Doro picking up a back block as a blocker at the end of that jam, knocked Megan Tron down after hitting her in illegal target zone. Tri-City over the century mark, 104-62 is the score right now. 42 points separate these teams. 24 minutes, 20 seconds remaining in this game on the Fast Girl start line. Peanut Butter Panic taking the star, going up against Smashing Good Time. Smashing Good Time, 10 points in the first half.
On the floor, we'll start 4-on-4. Smashing Good Time goes outside, then in, and is started to, an engagement is started by three blockers. Full strength now for Tri-City, lead jammer for the Thunder.
It's the third lead jammer status for Tri-City in this half. 3-2 is the total.
Smashing Good Time went outside, will now find a little bit of daylight, but it gets shut up quickly by the Berlin Bombshells.
Direction of gameplay on Andy Slamberg, trip number 4 for her.
This team's hatchet taking the largest number of penalties for Tri-City.
Heavy rotation joining her in the penalty box, trip number 4 as well.
Peanut Butter Panic removes the star, she will fight through as a blocker. 5 points for the other side. That's Tri-City up 109-62. Peanut Butter Mech has received the star pass and has emerged from the pack.
Pivots from Bear City doing good work getting out once they take those stars.
Will Tri-City call it off in time to keep it scoreless?
No.
But only 2 points yielded. A 7-point net jam for Tri-City. They'll go up 113-64.
Yeah, it was a 9-2 jam. 22 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in this game. Powerdyne, cutting-edge designs, cutting-edge performance. Check them out. They're Powerdyne.
Without sounding way, way too urgent, Mia Misso coming to the Fast Girl start line against Crazy Squirrel. It seems go time for Bear City.
Seventh jam, only 9 points for Mia Misso, but lead jammer's going to go to Squirrel.
Crazy Squirrel so quick, as is Mia Missile, but Crazy Squirrel getting the better of her opponent. She'll attack the pack and call it while being surrounded.
Not in time, though. Oh, no, no, wait. Crazy Squirrel got one single point. Mia Missile thought that she had points. Going to be a little discussion in the middle of the pack. The coach not so happy that his skater did not get anything after that leap by Crazy Squirrel. Kind of leapt the apex over her own pack of black blockers. We're gonna get a timeout. It's an official review, no less, being taken by Bear City. That's a really early official review, especially if you, I mean, if he's 100% sure that he's gonna be able to win this official review, cool. But at the moment, you're trailing by 50 points. You've got three clock stoppages.
I'm just spitballing here, Lou, but think about this. If say they're, and we'll find out what he's questioning, but if it's something really bad, like an egregious back block, who knows?
Bear City review for the first period, requesting a back blocking penalty on the Tri-City jammer. We'll discuss it.
There you go.
And that's on Crazy, that would be,
would
on,
be
crazy
on Crazy
squirrel.
Squirrel.
So that is, that could be a game changing type position.
Yeah. But again, you're rolling the dice. I mean, you are. I mean, you're using your OR 8 and a bit minutes into the half. It's one of those things you like to keep in your back pocket. But if they win this, Bear City will make us all look. Well, they'll make you look smart to make me look foolish.
Well, I called it egregious. I mean, that's what I figured. But so degree is what was where we'll draw the line there. A 50-point lead by Tri-City.
Wftda would like to thank our hosts, the Lansing Derby Vixens. I've been to a lot of these tournaments, Danny Mac, so have you.
Yep.
And we usually are treated very well, and the Lansing Derby Vixens have treated us amongst the best we have ever been treated.
I concur.
At these tournaments. They have been great hosts, and we give them great thanks.
And we'll hear firsthand what the call is. Again, the question revolves around Bear City wanted a back block called.
After review, the Tri-City Jammer landed the jump, bounced off one of our own players, and contacted a legal target zone of white 247. No call will stand. Bear City does not retain their review.
I can see on the Bear City bench, Catherine Beater Bones, who is the individual they were discussing, is holding her back and pointing to her coach saying, that was not a legal target zone. However, the officials did not see it as such, and therefore, Bear City is not going to win that official review. So they're going to be down to two clock stoppages, Danny, trailing by 50 points to Tri-City. We've seen them put big points up in a hurry. We saw that at the end of this half.
That's it. We've seen one instance where they've had that big enough scoring outburst to really put that question in Tri-City's mind. Jane Van Payne goes to the outside. She's facing Megatron on the Fast Girls start line. Megatron grinding against a four wall of Bear City blockers. Megatron will try to sneak around the outside, whereas Jane Van Payne will begin to dip and duck inside to outside. Jane Van Payne tiptoes, stays inside, takes lead jammer.
First lead jammer status for Bear City in the last four.
Jane Van Payne re-engages. She's now on a scoring pass. Megatron at the front of the pack being swallowed by four Bear City blockers who are also keeping at bay Rain Blows Bright, who's trying to get in and cause a little chaos.
Yeah, she's one of the pest blockers who likes to come in and break up those links.
114-64, the current score. Jane Van Payne on a scoring pass, being held at bay by Tri-City. Tri-City will bridge. Jane Van Payne still being held at bay by two blockers. Annex is one of them, and Antastic the other. Rainbow's Bright will take a penalty. Back block. She'll sit for 30.
She was a little surprised by that penalty. Didn't think she was doing anything that would warrant it.
Wow, Tri-City again holding Bear City to what could have been a major scoring swing, and it's only single digits.
Yeah, 5 points scored by Bear City. Megatron showing great patience during that jam. Yeah, she's not getting out. Yeah, she's not scoring any points, but she didn't take a penalty.
Right.
And she trusted her pack, and that's one of the things that they've talked about. Tri-City has talked about this weekend. They have talked about embracing the spirit of the alpaca, that they like to stay together in packs, and they die when they're alone. So
Don Erdoro jamming for Bear City. I love that analogy. Crazy squirrel for Tri-City. Don Erdoro sucked up backward, and will have to reset as she's slammed out of bounds by Skelton. Skelton again working one-on-one, and then will pass it off to the rest of her blockers, who are able to recycle forward and keep Don Erdoro back. Crazy Squirrel, in the meantime, doing a lot of the same up front, doing it more in a rotational style with three blockers and then the quick burst. Crazy Squirrel steps over a couple of jammers on the inside part of the track and takes lead jammer. Star pass successful to Catherine Beater Bones. Crazy Squirrel calls it. 4 points.
Skelton heading to the penalty box at the end of that jam. Yep, 4 points in favor of Tri-City. 118-69 the score. 18 minutes, 34 seconds remaining in this game. S1 Pro knee pad. Stability, function, durability, and superior shock absorption makes the S1 knee pad built for roller derby. S1helmets.com. Fast Girl start line is going to see Peanut Butter Panic facing off against Smashing Good Time.
Peanut Butter Panic goes to the inside, takes lead jammer.
She is the lead scorer for this team, but that's courtesy of one single jam of 27 points. She has 31 total.
Lou is grinding as we've seen some of these packs go. That one was a quickie. Peanut Butter Panic gets through again and will now engage the other blocker on the way out of the track. That's Smashing Good Time heading to the penalty box.
And last time Peanut Butter Panic was out there with a power jam, she put up 27 points. That would go a long way to getting Berlin back into this contest.
Boy, do they need it. Five already on the board, and she will be dragged back by Pitya Fu. key block for Tri-City. Peanut Butter Panic will now try to leverage a three wall of Tri-City, but be sent out of bounds, calling it off.
No, she wasn't 100% sure that she was going to call it off. She did the phantom wave, but then, yes, the coach told her, yeah, get the hands and hips. It's time to get this jam done. We're going to get ourselves a power start. A smashing good time is standing in the Triple Eight penalty box. 8-0 in that jam for Peanut Butter Panic and Bear City. Score 118-77. Just under 17 minutes remaining in this game. It's going to be Mia Missile with a star in her helmet. Only able to put up 9 points on the board. Pivotal part of this four jammer rotation Bear City puts up needs points in this jam.
16 minutes, 45 seconds to go. Mia Missile, quick work, and will become lead jammer.
Crazy Squirrel was out there as a pivot, Danny Mack, and picked up a penalty immediately.
Smashing Good Time had returned from the back. You wonder, would she have been past the star in that situation?
I think that was probably the strategy, but it's not going to happen now.
Nope, four more points for Bear City. 81 now for them, 118 for Tri-City. Forearm called on Tri-City's jammer.
Smashing Good Time, back-to-back jams with back-to-back penalties. And now Skelton heading to the Triple-A penalty box. Wheels starting to fall off the Tri-City wagon.
Briefly, and Mia Missile is picking up those pieces, 14 points. They now have 91 and trail by 27. Mia Missile will meet furiously at the front of the pack and get through Violent No Regard.
And this is what we know of Bear City. When you give them an advantage, they are well able to take it.
You wondered who was going to step up this season in place of Master Blaster, and you're seeing one of them. Mia Missile, great footwork on the outside. Rotates around a seemingly great block. Got enough daylight to get through and take another five. 24 points total in this jam.
She had two 32-point jams yesterday against Cincinnati. She's got a great chance to break that, unless she ends the jam herself, which she does.
Wow.
28-point jam, making it the biggest scoring jam for Bear City in this game, beating the 27 that Peanut Butter Panic put down at the end of the first half. And just like that, Tri-City lead is down to 13 points, and we got half a half remaining.
Bear City right back in this one, and a timeout will be charged to Tri-City. Perhaps a momentum call.
Triple Eight, the new helmets that protect against rotational violence with MIPS, patented brain protection system, triple8.com. This is the closest score the score has been since jam number 7. It's a long time ago.
Yes, it is. Lou, that's the Mia Missile we've expected in this bout, and finally we got an opportunity to see it.
Well, she got the free and open spaces that she likes, the speed, the agility. You got the Tri-City penalty parade happened, and there was a lot of room for her to maneuver out there. 28 points up in a hurry. She could have had more. She called off this jam before she got full value for it, but I guess they don't want to waste her completely.
I'll tell you this, it's awfully difficult to have better fitness than this Berlin Bombshell team. So if they can get that pack quickening, they may be able to wear Tri-City down a bit.
That was the third double-digit jam of the game for Bear City, coming at a very opportune time. So I guess we'll have ourselves a race to the finish, Danny Mack. It's no longer a big gap anymore. It's single jam territory.
Out of the Tri-City timeout, Tri-City leading 118-105, 14 minutes, 50 seconds ago. There's the whistle. Megan Tron on the outside for Tri-City. The team from Germany will go with Jane Van Payne, who will be sucked back in the pack by Rain Blows Bright.
And another penalty to the Tri-City jammer. It's Megan Tron with a blocking out of bounds, Danny.
Jane Van Payne already has 16 points this bout, but has had some trouble when she's been on a power jam opportunity.
Four power jams to one in this half in favor of Bear City, and there goes lead.
Quick enough, they'll take that, will Bear City, and she is making fast work of open floor.
They don't have desperation anymore because the score is so close, they can close it with one. They were playing with desperation before this.
Rain Blows Bright was acting like the water bug at the rear of the pack as the Bear City Jammer, Jane Van Payne, entered competition. Jane Van Payne still being held up hard at the front of the pack. Andy Slamberg leading that brace.
Yeah, that Tri-City tripod has been very solid in this game. And another power jam coming up to Bear City as Megatron picks up a back block.
Bear City still has not scored. As Jane Van Payne continues to go inside of the track, will get sucked back in by that four wall of Tri-City.
4 points, Danny Mac. That's all Bear City's able to pick up in that jam that had two jammer penalties to Tri-City's jammer, Megantron. They will get a power start. They will have most of the 30 seconds to work with as Jane Van Payne got the hands on the hips to call it off. They will get Donner Doro out there, Bear City, in order to take the star. But solid defense by Tri-City, keeping them in the lead, 118 to 109, 12 minutes, 50 seconds remaining in this game.
Donner Doro, who has three trips to the penalty box and 13 points to her name. Donner Doro will go to the front of the pack, be walled off by three. That one will reduce to two as Tri-City has to bridge.
Bear City putting up 40 points over the last three jams, Danny Mac.
Bear City now one-on-one with Skelton at the front. Megantron standing in the penalty box. She'll be here in a matter of ticks of the clock.
Everyone going to the penalty box for Tri-City. Skelton, Smash a Good Time, and Cannonball Doll.
That,
here we go.
That was quick by Donner Doro. The lead is now only 5 points for Tri-City.
And only two blockers on the track, and one of them's in the queue, and neither one's going to be able to stop her, Danny.
Donner Doro, another 5 points this time. Make it 118 to 118. We have a tie bout. Donner Doro slides to the outside. We'll have to reset behind the blocker around her. That was Dangerous, who will then try to re-engage. Dangerous knocks her to the inside. Donner Doro has to start thinking about this one. What's she going to do? Because Bear City is currently not able to get her through on this jam. 9 total points with 39 seconds to go in the jam.
Miss Mercury picking up the other play block. That got Megantron out, Danny. Jam's gonna come to its conclusion. We'll see how many additional points. Another 4, 13 points, and Bear City is now in the lead for the first time in this game. It took them to 11 minutes and 11 seconds were left in the bout to finally leap into the lead. Those 13 points added to the previous 40 put them on a 53 to nothing run over the last four jams, 53 to nothing, Danny Mac.
Two leading scorers on the jam for their respective teams. Peanut Butter Panic out first. Crazy Squirrel behind her. Peanut Butter Panic, this pack has gone fast. We're talking lightning fast. This is about as quick as it's been all bout. Peanut Butter Panic catching up a little bit, but these skaters are on their horses. 60 Blitz even back there trying to maybe give a whip. And 60 Blitz will yield as the pack spreads apart some more. Finally, we see Peanut Butter Panic get up near her opponents and teammates, crossing for 3 points, one tacked on for Tri-City.
First points for Tri-City in the last six jams. Score now 125-119, Bear City in the lead, under 10 minutes to go. Yeah, for skaters that have played 230 minutes of roller derby this weekend, they were still hustling pretty hard out there. Adam Skates, hashtag color me Adam. AdamSkates.com.
Mia Missile up to the Fast Girl start line. She has a 15-point plus differential when she's on the floor as a jammer. 125-119, the Bear City lead. And Bear City, Mia Missile, lead jammer. Yeah. She kicked this rally off.
Mia Missile's got a huge smile on her face knowing what she's been able to do for her team.
Few play with the amount of visible joy as Mia Missile. A 6-point narrow lead with 9 minutes and 17 seconds to go. Mia Missile walled up out back.
Forearm penalty to Lizzie Slaughter lightens the pack load.
Pity a Fool walled up out front. She will emerge, but take a track cut. power jam for Mia Missile.
And a track cut to smash a good time to pivot. Tri-City having penalty woes in this second half, Danny.
Mia Missile, a grand slam, working for more. 11-point lead for Bear City. 8 minutes, 11 seconds, Mia on the outside.
Six jammer penalties for Tri-City in this half, five of them in the last five jams.
16-point lead, Mia Missile continues to work. She'll go inside and then around, signature move. One skate, she'll pirouette and fall, but get back up as Tri-City tries to recover and can't. Mia Missile, too darn quick. 140-119, the Bear City lead. 30 seconds left on the jam. Tri-City has emerged and they are in scoring position. Now Mia Missile, 3 points, finishing the jam with an 18-point total.
This game somewhat reminiscent of the Charm City Tri-City game in Tucson last year, where Tri-City built up a substantial lead over Charm City and Charm City came racing back in the dying moments of that game to take over and then soundly defeat Tri-City. Tri-City looking to recombobulate on the track.
Crazy Squirrel has 55 points. She'll be on the line for Tri-City. Berlin will send Jane Van Payne. Crazy Squirrel answers the bell. Lead jammer for Tri-City. The team from the Kitchener area will continue to move forward. Jane Van Payne right on her heels. This pack is gone quick. You just see that switch flip, and there goes Crazy Squirrel inside out. Three players around her. Now one player to beat who has turned around and is skating backwards. That was Miss Mercury. Actually, that was heavy rotation, number 505, and she is helping brace her pivot.
Amazon just picked up her sixth trip to the Triple A penalty box, Danny.
Annex the pivot for Tri-City, also bracing Agrosaurus. And this one has gone from Indy 500 down to stopped traffic. Rain Blows Bright will continue to move forward and perhaps join her mates in blocking. Crazy Squirrel has gotten free. 5 points for Tri-City. They break a small drought. 143 is Bear City's lead to 123.
A back block being called on Jane Van Payne, and now Crazy Squirrel has the free and open spaces to skate as the only scorer on the track.
Crazy Squirrel and Jane Van Payne talking to one another, but the pack has sped up. Now it's down to a crawl. Crazy Squirrel gets a whip from Ann X, who then gets thrust right into two white shirts, calling it off out of bounds.
See if any additional points. Yes, 4 more points in that jam. Tri-City winning that jam by 10, 13-3. Now down by 14 points. Bear City 146, Tri-City 132. 5.5 minutes remaining in this game. And the WFDDA would like to thank 888 Motor Skates, Roll Line, Bruce Skate Noose, and Sisu Mouth Guards. We're going to get a power start for Tri-City. Megantron taking the start on her helmet on the Fast Girl start line. Danny Mack down by 14.
No lead is safe at this point. 5 minutes and 16 seconds remaining. It will be Jane Van Payne staying in the box. She's now standing up. Megantron on the power jam, showing a lot of patience herself as she's taking what these blockers are giving her, which is not much. The Bear City blocking core has spread apart slightly, and Jane Van Payne, Megantron rather, on one skate will emerge.
Star stash being attempted. They got a star pass now, Danny.
Jane Van Payne had passed the star, and the player holding it getting called for a track cut. That is
Peanut Butter Panic.
Peanut Butter Panic, and you could think potentially that was by design immediately. As soon as Jane Van Payne returned, she is now sitting in the box. Skelton heading to the box for Tri-City. 4-on-4, both pivots in the sin bin. Megantron still grinding it out, trying to get around.
She's gonna call it off, Danny. Have it taken 5 points for Tri-City. Tri-City now trailing by 9. Bear City in the lead, 146, 137. 4 minutes remaining in this game. The WFDDA and Lansing Derby Vixens would like to thank these companies for their generous support of this weekend's event. Animated Skateboards, X-Pain Solutions, Next Level Skate Shop, Modern Surf and Skate, All About Derby, Fahrenheit Massage, the Firecracker Foundation, and LuLaRoe. Penalties 39 aside, Danny Mac. Must be why our score is so nice and tight.
Crazy Squirrel will start on a power jam. The pivot turned jammer is Peanut Butter Panic in the penalty box. She's standing up. She'll rejoin soon. Can Bear City hold this off? 3 minutes, 30 seconds to go. A 146 to 137 advantage. Peanut Butter Panic is back and fighting. Former pivot, now jammer, now lead jammer.
She really has had Tri-City's number when she's been able to stay on the track, Danny.
Bear City up by nine, trying to build. Can Crazy Squirrel get sent out? And she will get out of the pack, almost. She's being dragged back. Does she reset behind the player? Well, the player who drew a penalty will be sent away. That's why she's free. It's heavy rotation.
Jam's gonna get called off. No points gonna go up on the scoreboard. Five added by Bear, 151-137. Yeah, that was heavy rotation taking trip number five to the penalty box. Not a lot of time left in this game. 2 minutes, 46 seconds as a timeout has been called by Tri-City. They have two more clock stoppages. They need to maximize those stoppings of the ticker so that they can get as many jams in if they want to close this gap between them and Bear City. 14 points is the differential at the moment. And we should give some love to Fast Girl Skates. Fast Girl Skates, 9 years dedicated to making a faster you. FastGirlSkates.com. Danny Mac.
Lou, what do you do here? You've got 14 points. Obviously, you're going to try to get the best of what you've got out there with the pieces you're giving. Each team down blockers here. Yeah, in the penalty box and Andy Slamberg in the penalty box for Tri-City.
Heavy rotation for Bear City. The problem that Tri-City has right now is that really the only one putting up big points is Crazy Squirrel, and you can't run her in every jam. You might be able to if you use enough timeouts. They're going to try Megatron. Berlin, if they want, they can go Mia Missile and Peanut Butter Panic. They've been having a pretty spectacular second half together.
Megatron, a negative 22 scoring differential versus Mia Missile, who has 55 points and a plus 33. Mia Missile has been hot in this second period. She continues it. Lead jammer for Bear City.
If she wants to, she can run this jam the full 2 minutes. If she skates safe, she can nearly kill the entire clock.
Mia Missile has 14 point advantage and a 2.5 minute time left on the clock. Megatron had stashed the star and then returns it to her helmet. 4 points for the Bear City jammer.
Bear City coach indicates he wants the jam to keep on running. Mia Missile gonna keep on going.
Bear City will slow down the pack. Mia Missile emerges, 5 points. 160 to 137 Bear. And they'll give up a few points here as Megatron gets around for four. Working that clock, Mia Missile. As long as it can be tit for tat here, they will allow Megatron to score. They'll give her a hell of a fight for it, but they will take those points. 164 to 141, Bear City over Tri-City, make it more. 169 now.
The look on Mia Missile's face was pure determination as she absorbed that hit and made it through the outside of that pack.
28 point lead. You see that burst that we've been waiting for from Mia Missile. She comes up on the pack awfully quickly, and it's that move right before she makes contact that's often key for her getting through. There it is.
Low block to Catherine Beaterbones.
Mia Missile had turned on the jets, then took it in from a three wall. 5 points for Mia.
Mia gonna clear her penalty box.
23 to 8 is Bear City's advantage in this jam, and they are leading 174 to 145 at present.
There's the hands on the hips, Danny. Timeout being called immediately by Tri-City. 23 to 8 in that jam. Mia Missile looking to put the dagger in the heart of Tri-City. 56 seconds remaining in this game. 174-145. 29 points separating these teams.
It's doable. Danny.
It is doable,
however. But, yeah, there are many steps to get to that point.
Mia Missile able to put up a 28-point jam in this half and now a 23-point jam in this half. Went from scoring virtually 0 points in the first half. I believe she had 9. Now has 78 points total in this game. We talked earlier on in this weekend about what was Bear City going to do now that they don't have Master Blaster. Well, we have seen what they're going to do. They're going to roll out a squad of 4 jammers that jam just like Master Blaster. It's almost like they've been trained by her.
And yes, indeed they have, by the way. Mia Missile, 78 points. She is an emerging star for this Bear City team.
Crazy Squirrel needs to get it done for Tri-City. Peanut Butter Panic is the skater I would put out there for the Berlin Bombshells. Even though she had 3 penalties early on in this game, she's had great game since then, Danny.
174-145, Bear over Tri currently. 50 seconds left on the game clock. As soon as that ticks away, we will go to jam clock time. Peanut Butter Panic trying to bust up the middle. Annex trying to keep that from happening. An apex jump into turn 2, and Crazy Squirrel takes lead jammer.
Tri-City does have one more stoppage, 30 seconds left on the clock.
Crazy Squirrel will go outside, then deke inward. 3 players to beat. The Bear City tripod working her over. Crazy Squirrel
takes
called for a track cut.
That's going to end it, Danny.
Dunzo. 11 seconds remaining on the bout clock. You'll see a lot of patience now from Peanut Butter Panic, who has already stashed the jammer star. 2 seconds remaining on the clock. Peanut Butter Panic cannot call it off.
Oh, she's got to survive another minute of beating out there.
She has not even gotten through the pack for her initial scoring pass. 54 seconds on the jam clock. That's what we're watching.
Now, to be fair, Peanut Butter Panic could just back off and not do anything. That would be another option, but, you know, roller skaters.
174 points for Bear City, 145 for Tri-City. Peanut Butter Panic now in full laid-back mode, just trying to stay on her skates and upright.
She just had a side glance at the clock, Danny, seeing how much more time she has to be out there.
24 more seconds. Crazy Squirrel has 5 points. 24-point lead for Tri-City. The pack speeds up a bit. And Peanut Butter Panic has returned the star to her helmet. She is now in scoring position. 9 seconds remaining on the jam clock. Crazy Squirrel working inside, then back out. 24-point lead at present. Make it 3 for each. Unofficially, Bear City has won it.
Roaring back in that second half, Danny Mack. Fantastic effort by the jammer rotation of the Berlin Bombshells. Penalties, jammer penalties, this time switching up, affecting Tri-City. Sometimes that happens, though. You know, you've got the jammer refs switch up at halftime. You get the jammer refs got the hot hand.
And Lou, we were just waiting for that Berlin Bombshells offensive explosion, and we finally saw it at the very end. And the player that stepped up most notably was Mia Missile.
So 11 power jams in the game given up by the Berlin Bombshells. They gave up 9 of them in the first half. And Tri-City committing 10 jammer penalties. Only 3 in the first half, 6 in the second half. But the Berlin Bombshells, Danny Mack. The
8 seed coming in, and they are going to finish in 5th, winning 3 bouts in a weekend.
Tri-City had been posting the hashtag 9-5 as they were the 9 seed trying to finish 5th. It looked like they had a good chance to do it until 15 minutes remained in this game, but going to fall a little bit short. If they had won this game, it would have been the 8th upset of the weekend, and they would be tied with Berlin for the most upset wins in division playoff history. However, Berlin defends their upset queen title. They have 6, Tri-City has 5. Berlin's beaten them twice in one weekend. It took them a lot more time to do it, and it was a lot closer than last time. 95 points the first game, and 24 points this time around.
Bear City, the upset specialists in Division 2. 177-153, it is now stamped as a final. Bear City, 56th ranked in the universe. Tri-City, 59th ranked in the universe. We knew this was going to be good, especially after that first bout where Bear City won that one. Tri-City had a little bit of comeback in that, but Bear City too much. And we saw in a lot of ways the fitness level of Bear City came through at the very end. We thought they were looking gassed at first.
And then they
had another gear.
That's right. They found their second, third, and fourth win in the last 15 minutes of that game. Put down the hammer, took home the win. They're going back to Germany, fifth place.
Three wins in their pocket, too. That's only going to help them next season against some very quality opponents.
And you know, you say it's going to help them next season. We had that big question, the Master Blaster question. Master Blaster was always there to bail them out, would score 58% of their points at all of the division playoffs that they've been at before. How do you replace 58% of your points? Four-jammer rotation, Jane Van Payne, Donner Doro, Mia Missile and Peanut Butter Panic getting it done all weekend long. Everybody putting points up, jamming by committee. Danny Mac.
And they've done it. Lou, that was a pleasure working with you on this one. The leading scorers, Mia Missile, 78 points, trailed by Peanut Butter Panic with 50 points. For Tri-City, the leading scorer was Crazy Squirrel at 76, 35 points. For Megan Tron. Thank you for joining us on WFTDA.TV. Plenty of derby still left today. The 1 and 3 seeds Charm and Wasatch coming up at 4 o'clock. That will be for a medal. That will be for third place. Then later tonight, the marquee bout, the battle for the gold. Calgary, number 5. Charlottesville, number 7. Taking each other on at 6 p.m. on WFTDA.TV. On behalf of the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, for Lou, for our producer AK, I'm Danny Mack. Thanks for joining us. Take it easy, everybody.